Okay, but more or less I understand. But with the action that's been taking that's been taken, what kind of damage are we seeing with the environment and just the breadth and the expanse of the contamination?
Okay, so latest reports at this time, may mga sightings na po ng oil sa Cavite, which was also part of the projection released in Bulletin Number 2. So ang immediate damage kasi nito will be on organisms that are living in the surface water. So yung mga photosynthetic organisms po natin, and then following that, yung higher organisms sa trophic level, yung mga isda, na ito talaga yung directly impacting livelihood of our fishermen.
All right. Now, what should is there a system that we should undertake? In other words, a best practices act when it comes to controlling calamities like this, tragedies like this.
Okay, that's a very good point, a very good question. There are actually ways to prevent such things from happening. So ito po, nasa purview ng ating marina, nasa purview ng ating Coast Guard, kasi sila yung implementing agencies. So this will require that vessels, ships that are carrying oil should undergo routine checks and rigorous checks from the authorities. Kasi may permitting naman po tayo for that. And we have to ensure that companies operating these vessels follow those protocols. Okay. And then the other thing will be continual training of operators and yung manpower working the vessel. Okay. So additionally, may mga guidelines na kunwari masama ang panahon, then they can not be allowed to go out in the sea and do the voyage. So may precautionary measures that can be put in place, and there are those. Unfortunately, may mga instances lang talaga po na hindi natin kayang i-prevent.
Uh-oh. But let's say the damage has been done. Let's say, like now, is there a more modern or a more efficient way, for example, to arrest the spread?
Okay, so for this, what really works will be containment. So that's the deployment of booms, and then deployment of vessels, ships that are capable of siphoning off the oil from the surface water. At ito po agad yung na-deploy ng ating Philippine Coast Guard, which was also done last year when Princess Empress happened in Mindoro.
So we are fully equipped.
We can benefit from additional funding so that our Philippine Coast Guard and also the LGUs surrounding or near coastal areas where ships are typically plying on or traveling in can readily be deployed when something like this happens. So may technology po tayo, pero kailangan lang ng additional funding para yung ating Philippine Coast Guard at lahat ng communities magkaroon ng ganong kakayanan.
Uh-oh. Now, Professor, considering we're an archipelago, we are at danger when it comes to climate change, right? We have how many typhoons a year? I believe it was, they said more than 20. Do you believe we've come to a place or a time and a space where we really value marine science and the marine environment in the Philippines?
To be honest, and this is my personal opinion, I think we are far from that ideal situation. So this is something that I am appealing to all viewers. If possible, let us value our marine resources. Ang dagat po natin ay more than just the beach, the sandy beaches that you are seeing. Napakalaki po ng help Okay, so we have ecological services that we can benefit from in our archipelagic nation. Okay, so we get our food from the sea. We get a lot more from our oceans if we take care of them properly. And I am also putting it out there that we need more marine scientists for our country to be able to take care of it. We have to understand it. And for us to understand it, we need more scientists. So yung mga kabataan dyan, inaanayahan ko kayo na matuto more than just Finding Nemo or Aquaman. Hindi po yun ang kabuuan ng pagiging ng ating pagiging archipelago.
Well said, well said. Thank you so much for joining me today. I do hope to see you again. Associate Professor Irene Rodriguez from the UP Marine Science Institute. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Maraming salamat.